Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube, and in this video, I'm going to show you why I like to use DAX Studio when I'm writing some DAX that's somewhat complicated that I'm going to use over in my Power BI report. Stay tuned. If you're finding this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date on all the videos from both Adam and myself. DAX Studio, I like to use it a lot, and we talk about it a lot on our channel when it comes to performance tuning. This past week, someone asked me, "Hey Patrick, I need some help with some DAX, can you help me out?" And so I looked at the DAX, it was somewhat complicated, and I was like, open up DAX Studio. And they were like, "Why can't I use a little DAX editor in Power BI?" I'm like, it's great and you can, but there's a certain case that you have to go back and forth to do some things when you're trying to debug your code. And I like to use DAX Studio because it provides just a more seamless approach to doing it. And Marco and I did a video on debugging DAX using variables, and it's a great video, but this one's just gonna kind of take it to the next level. Let me give you the scenario. You guys know what I like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. Here's the requirements. Every time I click on a country, I wanna highlight the bar for the year that has the lowest sales amount. That's the first requirement. The second thing is I don't wanna include years that don't have a full 12 months, that hadn't made sales for the full 12 months. So I need to ignore that. So we're gonna start by creating a measure, and I'm gonna do some conditional highlighting based on the results of that measure. So we're gonna call it BTH, and we're gonna start with some code that looks like this, right? Except for me to make one quick change because we want distinct count instead of calculate. So we're gonna start with something that looks like this, and I wanna see the results because I know this measure works. It's an explicit one that we've been using, but I'm building my own measure right here in line, and I wanna test it out. I wanna see what the results is, right? So we're gonna say return, and then we're gonna take a look at this year total. Here we go, confident about this, and I get an error. Take a look at this error, right? It says, the expression refers to multiple columns. Multiple columns cannot be converted to a scalar value. Because a measure only returns a scalar value. Can't return this entire table that I'm trying to return. You can actually do this in Power BI. If I just copy this code, went over to modeling and said new table, boom, I could do it. Right? I could totally do this, but that's just a lot of work. And you guys know how I am. I'm not lazy. I'm just really efficient. I have to go back and forth, back and forth. Every time I made a change to the code and, you know, in my measure that I'm trying to construct, and every time I want to see what that table looks like, I got to go back, modify. Not efficient, right? So instead of doing that, I'm gonna use DAX Studio. Let's grab our little code here. Let's bring it with us over to DAX Studio. And what we're going to do is say define, paste this in here, evaluate, and just say year totals. Format it up. I like to use that format because it'll tell me if there's something wrong with my syntax. Looks like everything's okay, and I'm gonna run this. And I can clearly see that it's returning the sales amounts, and all these months for the corresponding years have sales, but I know 2020 does not, and so there's something wrong. I need to convert this row context into a filter context by using what? The famous calculate, and then boom, right? So now it's doing exactly what we need. Do you see why I like to use DAX Studio? So now I don't have to go back and forth, right? Now I can add more things to this code and continue to write this code and evaluate it and debug it before I get too far in it. So I can go step by step by step by step. Let me show you. So now let's add another little piece to the code, another little piece to the puzzle, because remember there was another requirement. Hey, we want to only include years that are complete, right? That have full 12 months. And so I'm doing a filter on that variable, and I'm saying only give me the rows where my month count is equal to 12, okay? So what we're gonna do, we're gonna do something really simple. Watch, we're gonna switch it up, run this, and now, boom, 2020 is gone. See what I'm doing? I'm just debugging this step by step, kind of like what we did in our video, Marco and I, what we did in our video, but now I'm able to actually see the tables, all right? This is cool, right? This is cool, I'm excited. So let's continue the journey. So the next thing we need to do is find the minimum sales amount amongst this list. So what we're gonna do is paste this in here. Let's format this up. And now I'm gonna return min year sales. I'm gonna drop this right here and run it. Uh-oh, got an error, right? What does the error say? The expression specified in the query is not a, because this is a scalar function. So I actually could take this over to Power BI now in a measure and run it. But if I wanted to see what it was in DAX Studio, this is what I'm talking about with this flexibility, right? If I run this now, I just put a little table constructor around it. Boom, there's my value. Or if I want to get fancy and name it, I can use this row function and then I can name it. I can call it min sales like that and close this off with a parentheses and run this. You can do this a couple of ways. And then we continue to write our measure. If we introduce another table, we, you know, stay in DAX Studio to continue to debug it. If we're just gonna do scalar values, we can actually head over to Power BI and finish this up. Let me show you. I'm gonna head to Power BI and I'm gonna show you how we finish this up and actually use it in the report. So what we did was I copied most of the code that I wrote. And then you can see here's the calculate table. Here's the filter, here's the minimum. I tucked the current sales into a variable and then I just use a switch function. I said, hey, if the minimum sales equal to current sales, make it this color, otherwise make it that color. And I just returned it, right? I didn't need any debugging because I was pretty confident that this was gonna work. Then I clicked on my bar chart, went to the rolling pin, went to data colors, clicked on that, chose fill value, watch this, bar to highlight, click okay. And now you can see for Australia, the minimum one is 2012. If I deselect it, notice it's 2018 and it's just completely ignoring 2020 because I don't care about 2020. I choose United States, United Kingdom. You can see how it's flipping between each one of the countries. What? This is bananas. This is great. I love DAX Studio because it provides so much flexibility and all the IntelliSense and all the different things that's built into it. All right, what do you guys think? Have you used this method? Is this something new to you? Or are you using some other tool to debug your DAX? Let me know. I'd love to know. Let's continue the conversation. Where? In the comments below. If your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, give me a big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.